Hey everyone, my name is Ha, and today we're going to learn how to install the Civilization 3 fantasy mod called Tides of Crimson. For those who are not aware, Tides of Crimson is a full conversion fantasy mod with many gameplay changes, including totally asymmetric fantasy civilizations, magic spells, brand new elemental system, AI improvements, and much more. Okay, to start, you'll want to make sure you have either the Steam or GOG.com version of Civilization 3. Tides of Crimson will technically work with other versions, but important features such as the elemental system will not work unless you have the Steam or GOG version. If you don't have one of these versions yet, I would recommend getting the Steam version since this allows you to play Civ 3 online. I'll have links to both Steam and GOG in the video notes if you need them. Now here I've already installed Steam, for example, and I'm going to search up Civ 3. Just make sure that when you do search that up that you are purchasing the Civilization 3 complete version. Right now it's on sale. It's a dollar and a half. I've never seen it more than $3 or $4, so very, very cheap. So just go ahead and get that installed, and we'll go on to installing Tides of Crimson. Once you've got Civilization 3, the base game, installed, you're going to want to navigate to the Tides of Crimson thread on Civ Fanatics, and I'll have this link in the video notes as well. Download both the, if you scroll down here a little bit, you're going to download both the full version and the patch. Just note that in the future, there may be only one download link since we do plan on releasing a new updated version with a full storyline, so that is going to be an all-in-one download eventually, so just look out for that. So I'm going to start by getting the full version here. Just click on that here. This download link pops up, and you're just going to hit the little green button here that's going to pop up right here, and that'll start your download. And once you have the full version and the patch downloaded, we'll be ready to install. So now our files are downloaded. Just make sure you have an unzipping tool like 7-Zip or WinZip. I prefer 7-Zip just because I feel like it's faster, but you can use either one. All we're going to do now is navigate to the folder where Civ 3 is installed. I'm going to reference the Steam version installation here, but I'll have both the Steam and GOG.com version directories in the video notes. All right, for Steam, we're just going to go into our hard drive here. We're going to go to Program Files. We're going to look for the Steam folder. And then it's going to be Steam Apps right there. Common. Sid Meier's Civilization 3 Complete. Conquests. And then Scenarios. So that's the path you'll want. I'm going to go ahead and open the full version that says 2.0 first. And that'll open up like so. I'm going to select all these files and drop them into this folder here. Just make sure you avoid dropping them into an area where there's folders. You definitely don't want to drop them in here. You definitely want to drop them in this area here. So I'm going to go ahead and just let go, and they'll start transferring over. If you already have an older version of Tides of Crimson installed, it will just ask you to overwrite, which you should. But if not, it should just drop the files in for you. And now we're going to do the same exact thing here with this patch file, right? So same exact thing, we're just gonna drop it in here, just like so. Just make sure you select yes to overwriting all existing files when you install the patch. Now in this case, we installed two versions, the full version and the patch. We'll wanna get rid of the older version scenario file and a README file, which are down here, since that can get a little confusing. Just keep whatever the higher version is, usually is what you want to do. So let's go ahead and delete these files here. You'll see I'm deleting the 2.0 version and leaving the latest version, the 2.91, intact. Now, I would recommend going through this README file when you get a chance. It just shows you how to install optional features such as the title screen and menu music, but we don't need to do that right now. Next, you'll want to take this folder entitled C3X and just cut and paste it into the Conquests folder. I'm just using Control and X here. I'm going to go to the Conquests folder, And I'm going to use Control V here real quick here just to paste. C3X is created by a gentleman named Flintlock, and it's an amazing Civ 3 mod that adds new features, improves the AI, and gets rid of some bugs. Luckily for you, it's included in the Tides of Crimson download, as you can see. Alright, now that we have this folder moved over, we're just going to double-click into it, and we're going to just double-click this install button here. And this is the message you should see here. Mod successfully installed. At this point, if you have the Steam version of Civ 3, your installation is complete, but you might want to stick around to see how to get into the Tides of Crimson mod and begin playing it. For those who have the GOG.com version of Civ 3, you're going to need to complete a quick extra step, which I'll show you right here. Alright, if you got the GOG.com version of Civ 3, you're going to navigate to the folder where you installed it. By default, it's going to be right here. GOG.com, Civ 3 complete. I'm just showing you where the folders are here, so you'll notice the files are not present, but you'll see files when you're navigating through this. So you're going to see three labels files here, right? And again, if you have the Steam version, you don't need to do anything here, but if you have the GOG.com version, what you're going to do is you're going to take this labels file that's plain, you're going to delete it, and then you're going to rename this one. The non-Steam file, you're going to rename that labels, okay? Just like that. And now you should be all set. All right, so now you're ready to play Tides of Crimson. You'll want to run Civ 3 first. I'm using the Steam version here as an example. Just make sure you go into your library here, right? Civ 3 complete, and then you're just going to hit play. All right, so on this screen here, what you'll want to do is you'll hit Civ Content, then search for the Tides of Crimson scenario file. This is a random map every time, but in the future, there may also be Tides of Crimson storyline mission scenarios here that you can play. Just depends on when you are watching this video. Okay, we're going to click on this version here, and we're in. Just select all your settings and you're good to go to start slaying dragons and burning down ice elementals. Please be sure to check out our other videos for specifics on how to start your first game of Tides of Crimson. For Civ 3 veterans who just want to know the differences between Tides of Crimson and vanilla Civ 3, please check out our Tides of Crimson new features video. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you found this video helpful. It really does help, and we'll see you next time.